Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this tutorial we will create a quiz. This question was asked in an interview. The question is like this: make a quiz that has four options and add 1 point if the answer is correct, deduct one if it is incorrect. Also, you should have an option to skip the question and quit the quiz. Design the quiz using dictionaries. Okay, so this was the question. So without talking much, let's begin with the video. So as mentioned in the question, we need to take the dictionaries. So dictionary is an unordered collection of data. It contains key and value pair. So here we'll take key as the question and its four option. So we can take strings as key. So we'll take the question and four option as key. And the correct answer of that question will be the value. So our key contains question and four option. Value is nothing but the correct answer for that question. And here we are taking key and value as strings, because question and four options are string, as well as answer also will be in the string form. So in the Python file, we need to take the dictionaries and key and value pair. But here we are taking key as the question and four option. Okay, so it will become very lengthy. That's why I'll take a variable to store the question and its option first. Then we can take that variable as key in our dictionary. So that is nothing but here I'll take a variable called q1 and I'll store my question and option here. In the notepad, we have 5 questions here. So I'll copy this. This is the first question. I'll copy. And here I'll take triple double quotes and I'll paste this. We are using triple double quotes because here we need multi-line string, right? That's why. If you want to write this string in the multi-line, then we can use triple double quotes. So here I'm using that. So Q1 contains the first question and four option. Next, I'll take another variable for the question 2. I'll take Q2. I'll copy the second question. Next, Q3. We'll take 5 questions in our quiz. If you want, you can take more. Next, Q4. Next, Q5. Okay, so I'll take Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5 variables and I'll store my 5 question and its options. Right, next we'll create the dictionaries. So I'll give my dictionary name as questions. You can give any name. So I'll use the curly braces. Next, here I need to mention the key and value pair. Here our key is nothing but Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, right? The questions and its options, we store that in the variables q1, q2, q3, q4, q5. That's why I need to take like this q1, and I need to mention the value. Value is nothing but the correct answer for that question. So the correct answer for q1 is a. q2, we need to give the correct answer also, right? Okay, so first we took the questions and multiple options in the variable. Here we are taking 5 questions. So I'll take 5 variables and I will store that string in that variable. Next, we'll create the dictionary. Here Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5 are the strings which contains question and multiple option. And the value is nothing but the correct answer for that question. Right? Now we are done with the dictionary. Next. First, we'll ask the user to enter his name. If you want, you can skip this part. But I'll ask the user to enter his name. So, to ask the user to enter the name, we'll use input function. And here, I'm using Python 3. So, by default, it will take input as string. Here, we want string input. So, no need to change anything. So, the entered name will be in the string form. It will be stored in the variable name. Next, I'll print a message. I'll welcome that person to our quiz. So hello name, welcome. You can ignore this if you want, okay? Next, we need to print the question. To print the question and its option, we need to iterate through the dictionary. So for that, I'll use the for loop. So I'll use for I in dictionary name, that is questions. So it will iterate through the keys. I will contain the keys of the dictionary. Next, I need to print I, that is nothing but the questions. Here, when we will iterate through the dictionary, I will contain the keys of the dictionary questions. So in our quiz, first we want to print the question and its option, right? And the key in our dictionary is nothing but the question and the options. So that's why I am printing I here. Okay, it will print the question and its option. The first question and its option. Next, we need answer for that question, right? We need to ask the user to enter the answer. So for that, I'll take a variable. You can give any name to that variable and I'll ask the user to enter the answer for this question. Enter the answer. And here we are taking the string input, okay? We'll ask the user to enter A or B or C or D as answer. So I'll ask the user to enter the answer and we'll store that in this variable. Here we want string input, that's why we are just using input function. So next we need to verify the answer. So we need to check whether answer, the user entered answer, will be stored in this variable. That answer is equal to the dictionary name is question I. So here questions of I is nothing but it will give the value of this key. Here we can see if the question 1 is printed here, if questions of I is nothing but it will give the value of that is nothing but A, the correct answer for that. So we are checking the user entered answer with the value of that key, that is nothing but the correct answer of that question. If it is equal, then that means the correct answer. So we can print a message like correct answer, you got 1 point, and I need a variable to store the score. Okay, so I'll take a variable name called score and initially I'll take this value as 0. Before starting the quiz, the score value will be 0. If the user will give the correct answer, then I'll increment score by 1. If the entered answer is correct, then increment score by 1. Else, if the entered answer is not correct, if it is wrong, if entered answer is not matched with the correct answer, then I'll print wrong answer, lost 1 point, and I need to decrement score by 1. So you'll get negative marking here. If the answer is correct, you'll get +1. If the answer is wrong, you'll get -1. For example, there are 5 questions here in this quiz. If you give wrong answer for all the 5 questions, then you'll get -5 as your score. Next, we'll come out of this for loop and we'll print the score. Final score is, the score variable will contain this result, so score. So this for loop will iterate through all the key and value of the dictionary. So that is nothing but it will print all the question and option. And it will ask the user to enter the answer. It will verify the answer. If the answer is correct, the score will be incremented. If answer is wrong, score will be decremented. Next, after coming out of this for loop, we'll print the final score. Okay, so first we'll execute this program. Enter your name. So I'll enter my name as... So hello Amulya, welcome to the quiz world. Is Python case sensitive when dealing with identifier? This is the first question. Options are A, yes, B, no, C, machine dependent, D, none. So enter the answer A, B, C, D. You need to mention A or B or C or D. Okay. If I enter A and enter, it will give correct answer. You got 1 point. Next, it will print the next question. Which one of the following is not keyword? So if I enter A as the output, so it will give correct answer, you got 1 point. Which one of these is floor division? So if I enter A for this, and if I enter this, wrong answer, you lost 1 point. It will print the next question. Okay, so enter the answer. So next question is, what is the output of 3 into 1 into 3? So if I answer it as C, enter. Correct answer, you got 1 point. Next, it will print another question, that is A plus BC. What is this? Okay, if I answer it as D and enter, correct answer, you got 1 point. So total final score is 3. And if you want, you can print this score here also. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, it will ask the user to enter the name. So if I enter, hello Amulya, welcome to QuizBot. Is Python case sensitive when dealing with identifier? This is the first question. A, B, C, D options, and enter the answer. If I enter A, okay, so correct answer, you got 1 point. Current score is 1. And next it will print the next question, that is, which one of the following is not keyword? So I'll give the answer as B and I'll enter. So it will give wrong answer, you lost 1.0. So next it will give which one of this is floor division. By mistakenly I pressed enter, so it will take that as wrong answer, you lost 1 point. So current score is -1 and it will give the next question. What is the output of this? So I'll give answer as A. So wrong answer, so score is -2. Next, if I take the output as D and enter the correct answer, so my score is -1. So final score is -1. So it will give output like this. So here, while printing the question, I'll take a print function, okay, for the new line. Okay, so this is the half of the program. Next, in the question they asked, you should have an option to skip the question and quit the quiz. So first we'll take this part, skip the question. So after printing the question here, before answering that, we need to give an option to the user. So that's why I'll take a variable name as flag1 and I'll ask the user to enter the input, that is, whether he want to skip this question or not. Do you want to skip this question? Okay, please enter yes or no. Yes in the small or no. Okay, you need to enter like this, yes or no. The entered input, that is flag one, is yes. You need to enter like this for the yes. Then I'll use the continue statement. So that is nothing but, here we need to give an option to the user whether he want to skip the question or not. Flag one, input, do you want to skip this question? I need to ask the user. If he mention S, okay, if he enter S, then that means I need to go to the next question. So for that I'll use this continue, which will stop the execution of the current statements and control goes to the beginning of the loop and I will become the next key. Okay, it will print the next question. So this is for skipping the question. So I'll show you. Hello Amulya, welcome to the quiz world. First question is Python case sensitive when dealing with the identifier, blah blah blah. So it will ask, do you want to skip this question? So I'll mention yes. You need to mention like this to skip that. So which will skip the question and it will ask the next question, which of the following is not a keyword? I want to skip this question also, I'll mention yes. Okay, which will give the next question. Do you want to skip this question? Yes. So again I want to skip this question. Yes. Yes, I want to skip this question. So final score is 0. So this is for the skipping question. Next one is, we need to give another option to quit the quiz. After printing one question, we'll give the option to skip the question. After answering one question, if he want to quit the quiz, then we need to give that option also. So for that, here I'll take another variable called flag2 and I'll ask the user whether he want to quit the quiz. So here also you need to mention in S or no, small letters. If flag2 is yes, If he want to quit, then we'll take break statement. That is nothing but come out of the loop. When break statement will execute, it will come out of this loop and it will execute this statement, that is print function. Okay, it will print the final score and it will end the execution of the program. So we need to take this condition for quitting the quiz. We'll give this option after attending at least one question. So here is the output. Enter the name. So if I enter, the first question will be printed. Do you want to skip this question? No. So enter the answer. So I'll enter as B and it will check wrong answer. You lost 1 point. Do you want to quit the quiz? Okay. If you mention yes, then it will quit the quiz and it will print final score is -1. If you don't want to quit this quiz, then you should mention no. So it will continue the execution. Okay, like this. Okay, so this is about this. One more thing. First, it will print the question. Next, we'll ask whether you want to skip this question or not. If you give yes, then it will print the next question. It won't ask whether you want to quit the quiz. If you want to ask the user whether you want to quit the quiz before printing the question, then you can cut this code and you can place here. Here you can place that and you can do that. So you can modify this code however you want. Okay, so this is about the quiz program. We'll see the final output now. So enter your name. So the first question, do you want to skip this question? No. Enter the answer. Yes, 1 point. No, I don't want to quit. Which of the following is not a keyword? Do you want to skip this question? No. Answer is A. So correct answer, score is 2. Do you want to quit? No. The third question, do you want to skip? No. Answer is C. Okay, I lost a point, right? So now it becomes 1. No. So here we can see, do you want to skip this question? Yes or no? I printed C. So I entered C. It will continue the execution because if you enter S, then only it will stop the execution. Okay. If you enter any other key, it will continue the execution of the program. The score is 2. So current score is 3. Do you want to quit? No. So the final score is 3. Okay. So this is about this program. Here we can see there are 5 questions and out of 5, 4 was correct, but we got score as 3 because of the negative marking. If you give the wrong answer, 1 point will be deducted. That's why if you don't want this, you can remove this and you can execute the program. That's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.